Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bastion Slot, and we are back playing Jurassic World the game, and we are ready to knock out a couple of missions. Primarily, first things first, this one, collect 80,000 coins from dinosaurs. This should be hunky-dory easy-peasy. If it's not, then something has gone terribly, terribly wrong. So let's go ahead and collect some coinage and see if this works. Splendid! Splendid. Give me things. I'm a little worried, guys. I'm using, basically, the program I use to record the iPad is called Reflector, okay? For those of you curious, a lot of you have asked, to record your iPad, I use Reflector, and what this does is it uses AirPlay to sort of wirelessly mirror the screen. Now, Reflector has just upgraded to Reflector 2, so if it's a little weird at the start, for some reason I've not yet discovered, I do apologize. And if it is, then I'll go back to Reflector 1, frankly. Anyways, yes, among others, would you care to see them? Yes, if you wouldn't mind. Big day tomorrow, huh? You must have a lot on your mind with the press conference and all. I could, you know, show you around if you'd like. No, I think I'd rather be alone for a while, Mr. Grady, but thank you. I did it! Eh. Oh, we're going to level up. Which means, Pteranodon, the Resolute. It is only the Resolute who shall overcome the obstacles of ignorance. Is this going to be a new thingamajiggy? Ah! Oh no, we already did Pteranodon. Ah, it's a Velociraptor, that's more exciting. Ah, it's a mystery pack. Ah, gold. Ah, DNA. Ah, that thing. Ah, don't care. No. No, yes. Yeah. What's my other mission? Oh, that one's dead easy as well. Alright, let's collect our gold. Delicious, nutritious gold. Ah, what am I doing? Hello. I love you, Diplodocus, but I didn't mean to click on you right now, so sorry. Okay, let's get that on the go. Let's collect our free pack. Food, DNA, journalist, power generator. All these things I don't care about. No. And our mystery pack at the start of every episode, which seems... Oh, dinosaur. I was about to say, they seem really determined to not give me a dinosaur. But there we go, we've got another Benitosaurus. Which apparently is Portuguese. Well, Benito's Portuguese, anyway. Somebody told me Benito's Portuguese. Anyways, let's get that mission done. So let's grab this. Shift it up here. Is this what I'm meant to be doing? Is it the hotel? Yeah. So we just need to move all the... I'm going to try to remember where these came from. That's important. So one from the far left. One from the far right, which is where the hotel also came from. And then one from by the Triceratops. Let's remember that. If I forget, folks at home, you need to remind me, okay? Thank you. Boop! Zara, I know you... Wait, no. Zara, I know you are faithful to your job, but I must have access to these files. It is important. Barry, if I get caught... It will not happen, I swear. It will be our secret, yes? Hey, there's a photocopier behind my desk. Thank you, thank you. You are the pure sunshine of my life. That's a weird thing to say. Don't let anyone see you. And you copy all 342 pages yourself. And you owe me... Sorry. Moving on.
It's time for another matchup in the arena.
I did it. Barry, you're rubbish. You never give me the quest at an appropriate time. It is only the tenacious who step forth and... unlatch the gates of truth. Members of the press, we at Jurassic World remain tenacious. We remain resolute to John Hammond's vision, his life work, and his gift to mankind. I thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us today. Let the prehistoric inhabitants of Jurassic World inspire you by uncovering an extraordinary world lost by time. ... Episode 13, Gift to Mankind. And two more missions! The Inside Hour is having trouble broadcasting their coverage of Jurassic World. I wanted to bring this to your attention. The producer mentioned electronic interferences on Isla Nublar. Maybe it's something to do with our island advertising. Should we relocate the signs? Perhaps it might be worth a shot.
Whoa, okay. That's easy enough. Do I have three power generators? That might be a problem. I've got two, and the game just gave me one. Now I've got three. Cool, okay. So let's move all this stuff back. Hotel goes here. Security tower goes... Come here. Come here, you little goose. Security tower goes there. security tower goes. There. I don't like that path. Not one Dickens. Or that one. There we go. It's better. And final security camera goes over here. Okay.
You know, I think I might have found a way for Blue to respond to our commands better. Velociraptors are very quick learners. They get smarter with every passing day. I'll need your help with these new tricks. We'll try it on other carnivores first as a simple test.
I don't have two geysers, so we're going to have to buy a geyser. Which is in decorations and costs not that much, actually. Now, where's my other one? It needs to be next to the other. Okay, it's fine. Got a plan. Move the raptor out the way. Remove that path there. Geyser goes in. Everyone is hunky-dory. Yeah. We might actually hit level 24 on this. We might actually have two battle arenas to do, which would be really cool.
Blue didn't seem to mind that much. Great job. Maybe we can teach you something else in the future.
Go on, give me an easy mission.
Yes.
I don't have an accent for this guy, sir. The other three have an accent so far. Right, we'll go Irish. Because I can speak in an Irish accent, obviously. Blue is growling. You cannot sneak up on her. Hoskins, if she knows. That raptor is getting pretty good at detecting people she doesn't like. Shame she's nothing more than a glorified watchdog. You know why I'm here. Did you get them? Just a moment, please. I feed my animals first and then we talk. Feed for herbivores, feed for... that's going to be difficult. Actually, maybe it won't be. The amphibians one is going to be tough. I think all my amphibians are leveled. I need to do something with this. Let's sell the coffee shop. Or... oh, actually, there's room there. There's room there if I get rid of a bit of path. There. Let's make it look nicer. Lovely jubbly. This specific area of the park up here in the north, beyond the wall, is particularly boosted, shall we say. Right. So, amphibians. I can feed... wait, how many amphibians do I need to feed? Three. I can feed one so far. I suspect that might be my limit right now, unfortunately. Herbivores is easy enough. I think I've actually got the herbivores ready. Amphibians is definitely a problem. All my amphibians are max except one. And I'm assuming it has to be four separate amphibians. Which is a bit of a pain. However, just in case it's not four separate amphibians, what's the bonus on that? 5%? What do you want? 2%? Let's feed it. Let's see if it works. No, does that count as one? Yeah. Right. Okay, so it means we need some amphibians if we're going to do that mission. What's the other mission? Move three power generators. Easy, easy, easy. Okay, well, let's do that. Which amphibian? It's seeing one of my amphibians already has four decorations around it. Ah, cheeky. Bloody Limoncello is racking up the bonuses. That should do that. Yep, there we go. I actually want these over here, though. Do I? It's all so messy. It needs redoing. I've got a billion of these raptor statues out of nowhere. Hello. Right. Move three power generators. Okay. Easy peasy. One. Two. Three. And straight into the battle arena to unlock a Velociraptor and level 24. Productive. Oh my god, that's lots of... wow. Carnivores beats herbivores. Herbivores beats flying. Flying beats aquatic. Aquatic beats that. Right, no. Before we do that, we have to level up our Meteorhynchus. Because this guy is perfect against the raptor. And I'm a little... I don't think I'll manage it otherwise, frankly. Because... you know, it's three super rares, which isn't really something we've come up against before, so... let's get ourselves a level 20 Meteorhynchus. Which was always the idea, anyway. Who looks exactly the same? Slightly different colouring on his belly, I suppose. The raptor had about 500 health. I mean, this can't be that far behind. The raptor was, what, level 20? Still quite far behind. 25, yeah, okay, it's a bit of a difference.
Not like this.
I'm trying to decide if Ankylosaurus or Tapioca is my best bet. I think... I was going to say, is the 50% that big a deal? But I think it is big enough a deal to make it so that we go for Tapioca. Right, no. We're changing this. I had a better plan. We're going to lead Suchomimus. We're going to finish with Metrorhynchus because I want to make sure by the time Metrorhynchus comes out, I've had the opportunity to build up like all of my points. So for that extent, we should probably lead with Trope. Because your weaker dinosaurs are going to have less points to use because for the first four turns, they don't get any, effectively. So while Trope may die really quickly, it'll benefit my point production. This is going to be quite tough. I'm not filled with confidence for this fight, guys. I'm not going to lie. I'm not filled with confidence. But I've been fighting well lately. So, let's see. Just going to put this out there right now. I love the look of that raptor. That is so cool looking. What are you... Stop it. Ah, the agony. Ah, the agony. The raptor looks so cool. That colouring is amazing. Look at it. It's fit. That's a kill. Whether Metrorhynchus can handle the rest of it, I'm not really convinced. I'm not going to lie. Is this a kill? Damn it. If he'd survived that, it might have been doable. This is going to be near impossible. But we shall see what we can do. I'm just going to double block. Because that's a kill. This actually might be okay. He comes out, he attacks, I double block, I don't think he gets the kill in, I put all 4 points into attack. Let's hope he uses all 4 points. Okay, he used like none. I'm going to just double that. I'm a little worried that he's just put 4 points into boost. He's about to hit me for 7 and I'm definitely going to die. 3. That might not be a kill. Yes! That block saved my life and now I've got a lot of points. He doesn't have any defense. Blow his face up. Blow his face up! Oh, he has a bit of defense. Yeah, I knew that. Phew! Whew, that was close. Bloody Nora. Well done, Metrorhynchus. You carried me there, babes. You absolutely carried me. Tropognathus, Mr. Tapioca. Utterly freaking useless. Right. We've had that Pyroraptor ready for ages. Ooh, a lot of DNA. Moving the island advertising seemed to have helped a bit. Some television producers say they're getting a clearer signal, but obviously the problem is still here. We'll have to contact the control room for help. Level up! I think that is... Ooh. Is that a Pelicanimimus? In which case, we'll be able to evolve it. Why don't you give me dinosaurs anymore? Did I do something to hurt you? I just want dinosaurs. I just want you to love me like I love you. Actually, we can do that mission really easily. Let's just level up one of our Coryphosauruses to level 8. Splendid. $10 dino, please. Thank you. Okay, next mission. Nothing we've tried so far has really worked so far. Her voice kind of changed. Television networks still can't seem to broadcast their live coverage today. Lowry? I can't do multiple female voices. There's no way I can be female in two different ways. Maybe we can do a female Irish accent. Lowry, earlier I asked you and the engineers to put your heads together. We need some ideas fast. Okay, how about this? We got the networks and wonder equipment into the comm station and mobile centres. Then we amplify the signal from our dish to bust through whatever the heck is messing up their broadcast. It's a long shot. I'll take it. Zara, you coordinate with television crews. Tell them they need some extra long cables. Yes, Miss Deering, but don't they all speak different languages out there? I only know English and a bit of Mandarin and Spanish. Figure it out! Well, that's easy. Oh, we can do that. Yeah. What's our next battle then? Pelicanimimus. Cool. How long to wait? It's so tempting. It's so tempting.
Oh, right, okay. So many dinosaurs. I mean, these, like, the Diplocaulus and the Limoncello has been there for bloody ages. It really has. Oh, God. And we're actually going to need the Diplocaulus. Actually, let's start getting the... I don't care if it's a few dollars. We need things like these Diplocaulus, otherwise we're never actually going to do the mission. So let's start getting them on the go. I'll do that myself, but I won't feed the herbivores, so you guys will be here when the mission gets completed. Let's get this one done quickly. So we need to move a power generator next to a hotel. Are there any hotels that I can actually get to? Yeah, this one. Come here, you. Come here, you cheeky son of a gun. Boop. Done? Oh, security office. Oopsie-daisy. There we go. Lovely jubbly. Security office goes next to the hotel to protect the people of Jurassic World. And then we just need to grab our free power generator and buy another one. There we go. So in an hour, that mission will be done. I tell you what, we're flying up the missions. So that'll be finished. That's 27,000. When did I feed another amphibian? What? What? Am I missing something? Who did I... But I didn't... I fed Coryphosaurus. Did I feed him? I'm just going to feed this, see if that helps. Did that help? I don't understand. I'm very confused. Have I completely forgotten feeding... Oh, of course. We fed the... Of course? Yeah, we fed the lower level Metriorhynchus up to level 10, evolved the Metriorhynchus, and then... Which seems to have like a thing on its back now. Again, it's got like something from the sky. That you see that like grey line where its leg is? It's got something from the sky that it doesn't have in person. Same with the Junkosaurus. So yeah, we fed the lower level Metriorhynchus up to level 10, evolved it, and then that was a new Metriorhynchus, and then we evolved that up to level 20. So we actually only need this Diplocaulus, so that mission is going to be pretty easily knocked out in the next episode. So is that one, which means we'll probably level up, which means we can kick off with a Pelicanimimus battle arena, and then probably do another battle arena straight after. We are flying through the game, flying through it! Thank you very much for joining me, though. As always, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've enjoyed Jurassic World Week as much as I have so far, and I shall see you lovely people in the next episode. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.